أما بعد، last week we talked about the Muslim and who is the Muslim. Today we'll talk about very important hadith related to the mu'min, to the iman. And we said, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, المسلم من سلم المسلمون من لسانه ويده. The Muslim who doesn't harm Muslims with his tongue nor with his hand. Today we will talk about a hadith that reported by two Sahaba, Abu Huraira and Anas bin Malik, and we talked about them both. This hadith, both of them, they report the same words from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They said the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, لا يؤمن أحدكم. No one will have iman unless حتى أكون أحب إليه من ولده ووالده والناس أجمعين. In hadith that reported by Abu Huraira, there is no والناس أجمعين, which is, he said, there is no one will have iman unless I'll become more beloved to him more than his own son and his own father and all mankind. So in hadith Abu Huraira, there is no all mankind. And in hadith Anas, at the end, there is addition, which is all mankind. And there is another narration in Muslim that the Prophet ﷺ said, unless I'll become more beloved to him more than his family, his money, and all mankind. So this is the narration of the hadith. So now, this is related to the iman. And the Prophet ﷺ said, لا يؤمن أحدكم. No one will have iman unless he have these things, which is loving the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam more than his children, more than his parents, more than everyone else. And before we talk about the hadith, we should know why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the other hadith said al-Muslim, and now he's talking about iman. What the difference between iman and Islam? The scholars, they said iman and Islam, إذا اجتمع افترق وإذا افترق اجتمع. They said if you put iman and Islam in one talk, they will be different. There is a lot of differences between them, but if you put iman alone, it will be equal to Islam. And if you put Islam alone, it will be equal to iman. So if you just say, I'm Muslim, it could be Muslim and mu'min, both. If you say, I'm mu'min, it could be Muslim and mu'min. But if you say, I'm Muslim, not mu'min yet. So there's differences. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about the Bedouin, said, don't say we are mu'min, say we are Muslims. وَلَمَّا يَدْخُلِ الْإِيمَانَ فِي قُلُوبِكُمْ. And when the iman comes to your hearts. So now we should go back to the hadith that reported by Umar bin al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala an, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam talking about the three reputation of Islam, like Islam, iman, and ihsan, to realize how the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam explained iman and Islam and ihsan to us. So Umar bin al-Khattab, he reported this hadith, authentic hadith in Bukhari. He said, while we are sitting with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, a man came to us. No one from us knows this person. He was shadidu sawad al-sha'r. His hair so black and his clothes so white. and no one knows him, and there is no signs of traveling on him. And he sat in front of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he's starting asking the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam about Islam and Iman and Ihsan. So he said, "Akhbirni anil Islam." He said, "Tell me about Islam." And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam explained Islam this way. He said, "Islam, to say ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, establish prayer, fasting, doing Hajj, charity. This is the arkan of Islam." That's how the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam explained Islam to him. And then he said, "Sadaqt." You said the truth. So Umar bin al-Khattab, he added to the hadith, he said, فَعَجِبْنَا لَهُ يَسْأَلُهُ وَيُصَدِّقُهُ. And we was wondering, like, he's asking him, and he said, "You said the truth," which is usually, if you know, you wouldn't ask. You ask if you don't know. It seems like he knows what the Prophet ﷺ would say. And then he asked about Iman. So the Prophet, Umar bin Khattab said, the Prophet ﷺ told him Iman, to believe in Allah, His angels, messengers, books, the last day, and with the Qadr, with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has written for you. خَيْرِهِ وَشَرِّهِ, the bad and the good, whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has written to you. And then he asked him about Ihsan. And he said, Ihsan is to worship Allah just like you see Allah in front of you. And if you don't see Allah, so you have to know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees you all the time. So now we see, well, we don't want actually to talk about this hadith. There is a lot of good things to say about this hadith. But we will talk about Iman and Islam. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam explained Islam as the appearance of Muslims, of the actions of Muslims, whatever appear from the Muslim. He say la ilaha illallah, he establish prayer, he doing charity, which is the zakah, the obligatory charity, fasting Ramadan, and go to Hajj if it's possible. So these actions of Muslim, if anyone do these actions, no one can say he's not Muslim, even though he has no Iman in his heart. If he doesn't believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, no one can point him as no Muslim, because it's whatever in your heart, is only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can judge it and see it. But Iman, it's something else. It's to believe in Allah, to believe in angels, to believe in the messengers, to believe in the books of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to believe in the last day, to believe in all the qadr. So this is Iman, what is inside, what is inside you. But again, all the scholars, they said Iman is qawl, which is saying, i'tiqad is belief, and actions, fi'l. Imam Shafi'i said, all the Salaf, they believe that Iman is qawlun wa fi'lun wa niyyah, saying, actions, and intention, which is belief. So now, how to know Iman from Islam? As I said, if we talking generally, Iman will be equal to Islam. Like I say, you are mu'min, you are Muslim, and I mean you follow this religion, the religion of Islam and the religion of Iman. You believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But sometimes if I try to be specific Iman will mean something else. It will be the Islam plus believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inside your heart. So if someone say La ilaha illallah, that's why the scholars, they said Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has honored La ilaha illallah in a way that it will be enough to say La ilaha illallah to be saved in this life, to will be treated as a Muslim. Just say La ilaha illallah, even though everyone knows that you don't believe in La ilaha illallah. When the Sahabi raised the sword and one of the mushrikeen said La ilaha illallah and he finished him, he went to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and said, like, Hilla shaghaqta an qalbi? He said, did you know what is inside his heart? The Sahabi, he said, I would make my Islam after this incident, because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was so angry about him. So he just say La ilaha illallah, it would save him in this life. No one can harm someone said La ilaha illallah. That's why the scholars, they said Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has honored this statement, La ilaha illallah, that even if you don't believe in it, you will be saved in this life. But in the hereafter, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will deal with you, because He knows, يَعْلَمُ خَائِنَةَ الْأَعْيُنِ وَمَا تُخْفِي الصُّدُورِ. He knows the sight when you just like have a look to something, and He knows what you hide inside your heart. So subhanAllah. So now, this is Islam. If you say La ilaha illallah and do follow the, like do the actions of Islam, you are Muslim. If you do this and believe in Allah, believe in your heart in all these teachings, you are mu'min, mu'min. And now the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam talking about iman. And when he said, لا يؤمن أحد, no one will has iman unless he loves the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But there is another hadith when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, لا يؤمن أحدكم. He said, لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى يحب لأخيه ما يحب لنفسه. It's a very famous hadith. Like, no one will has iman unless he like to his brother whatever he likes to himself. And there is another hadith, ما آمن بي من بات شبعان وجاره جائع إلى جنبه وهو يعلم. He doesn't believe in me, the one who sleep in his house full, and he knows his neighbor hungry, starving. So now the Prophet ﷺ said he has no iman again. And there is another hadith that لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى يكون هواه تبعا لما جئت به. This hadith is reported as authentic by Ibn Hajar and Nawawi, but there is some scholars, they talk about this hadith, they said it's ضعيف. But anyway, we're talking about the iman. And he said, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, in another hadith, he said, لا إيمان لمن لا أمانة له. The one who has no trust, he has no iman. So now, is the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم talking about the complete iman? Like, if you say shahadu an la ilaha illallah and you believe in Allah, you believe in the Prophet, you believe in the books, angels, but you don't, you are selfish, let's say you are selfish, you don't like to your brothers what you like to yourself, so you are not mu'min now, we say you are kafir, what do you think?
So mu'min but have foibles.
But the Prophet ﷺ said, "La yu'min." He said, "He doesn't have iman, or no one will have iman, will has iman." So, what do you think? Exactly.
Yeah.
So the scholars, they said, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, iman is wide. In hadith Abi Hurairah, he said, bid'un wa sab'un, or bid'un wa sittuna shu'ba. Iman is some, like 70 and some level, or 60 or some level. And he said, the best level of iman is la ilaha illallah, and the lowest level, imadatul adha an al-tariq, to take the harmful things on the street, take it away. This is also an action from iman. And he said, al-haya'u shu'batun min al-iman. There is no, I think you know haya, because there is no word equal to haya in English. Haya, it means, it's not shy actually. It means to be responsible and shy and have modesty in your life. All these together actually. All these together. This is the haya. And this, the Prophet ﷺ said, this is also a part of iman. So iman has parts. That's why we believe that iman is increase and decrease. Increase with good actions and decrease with bad actions. So this is what the Prophet ﷺ meant by saying, La yu'minu ahadukum. That's, no one will have complete iman unless he will do these things. Right? And this is the meaning of the hadith. And there is another hadith supports this meaning, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, من أحب لله وأبغض لله وأعطى لله ومنع لله فقد استكمل الإيمان. He said, whoever loves and hates for the sake of Allah, gives and stops for the sake of Allah, he complete his iman. So he said, complete his iman. So that means that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he said, la yu'minu ahadukum, that doesn't mean if he doesn't do this, he will be kafir. He will not be a mu'min. But he will not have complete iman in his heart, unless he would do all these advices from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So now, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى أكون أحب إليه من ولده ووالده والناس أجمعين. No one will have complete iman unless the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would be more beloved to him more than his own son, his own father, and all mankind. So first of all, why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned the son before the father? By the way, in Bukhari, it's the father. There is a narration in Bukhari, the father before the son. He said, walidihi wa waladi, his father and then his son. But most of the narrations, it's the son and then the father. The scholars, they said, that when you feel sorry for someone, like the shafaqa, I don't know what's the exact word. What is the exact word? I think for shafaq.
Sympathy or empathy.
Maybe sympathy. It's
to put yourselves in the other person's situation.
It's more to the children than the father. Sometimes you really like the children more than yourself and your parents. That's why the Prophet ﷺ starts with that, with the children. He said, you should love me more than the children. And the father and then all mankind. So the love to the children, and then the respect for the father, and the love for all mankind. It's started this children first, and the father, and the mankind. So that's why the Prophet ﷺ starts with the son. And why he said the father doesn't say the mother? Because we all, like, even the Prophet ﷺ, he advised us to be more dutiful to our mothers more than the fathers. So why he didn't mention the mother?
It's a different kind of love?
No. When he mentioned the son, do you think he doesn't mean the daughter as well? In Arabic, you can mention the kind. You say, no man will do this. And you mean all mankind. You say son, and it's referred to the son and daughter in Arabic. You say the father, and you mean parents. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam meant the parents. So when he said son, it means son and daughter. He said the father, it means father and mother as well. So we should keep this in our mind. So he means that we should love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam more than the children and more than the parents. وَالنَّاسِ أَجْمَعِينَ. So the scholars, they said there's three kinds of love. There's a love of shafaqa, sympathy. This is for the children. And there is a love of respect to the parents. And there is a love of mushakala, which is you like these people. And this is for the other mankind. So this is the three kinds of love. And you should put the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam more and above all these kinds of love. And why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam doesn't mention the when you love yourself? Because it's inside وَالنَّاسِ أَجْمَعِينَ, all mankind. So it's all kinds of love. And there is a hadith actually also reported in Bukhari, when Umar bin al-Khattab was walking with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Umar bin al-Khattab, sorry, told the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that, I love you more than everything except my nafs, except myself. Then what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied to him? He said, no. Until you love me more than yourself. And then Umar bin al-Khattab took a while and he said, now I love you more than myself. They said, Ibn Umar asked Umar bin al-Khattab, why? Like, how it comes? Like, it's 1 second and then you said, you love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam now more than yourself. He said, we should think how the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is important to us. Without the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, even our nafs, our soul, it will be in the hellfire. So if you love your soul, you should love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam more, because he saved you. He saved you from the hellfire. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put him as a shafi' for us, as a mercy for us. So now there is a one thing about the love we should say. So we love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam more than everything. That's what we said, right? So what about the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? We should love the Prophet ﷺ more than Allah. What do you think, Shaykh Ali?
No.
The love of the Prophet ﷺ is taba, it's a part of loving Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ فَاتَّبِعُونِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, say, if you love Allah, so follow me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would love you and forgive your sins. قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ فَاتَّبِعُونِ يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهِ. So if you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you would love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, النبي أولى بالمؤمنين من أنفسهم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, the Prophet has more value to the believers than themselves. That how they should think. And why is that? Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wants us to love him more than ourselves, more than our families, more than our money, more than anything else in this life? Why? Does he need this love?
If we love him more than ourselves or ourselves or other people, we will follow his orders.
Exactly.
Than
first of all, if you hate someone, you will hate listening to him. If you love someone, you will love to listen and see what he would say. You would love to go and do whatever he would say. So it's a start from here. If you love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, all the commands that comes from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, all the teachings that comes from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, will be simple and easy, because it comes with love. You would love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and it will be very easy to you to follow the orders. It will be so easy. And if you love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you would search for his seerah. You would search about his actions. You would try to copy him. And he is the best example that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent us. And you will develop your actions, your deeds, by following the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ شَاهِدًا وَمُبَشِّرًا وَنَذِيرًا لِتُؤْمِنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ وَتُعَزِّرُوهُ وَتُوَقِّرُوهُ. They said تُعَزِّرُوهُ is to support him, وَتُوَقِّرُوهُ is to respect him. Support him and respect him. To honor him. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He sent him as a mercy to all mankind. So again, to have complete iman, to have complete iman, you have to love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and you have to love to your brothers. And this is the signs of iman. The signs of iman. For example, he said the sign of iman to love the Ansar, and the sign of Nifaq to hate the Ansar. You know who's the Ansar? The people of Al-Madinah. The people of Medina. The Prophet ﷺ said, if you love Ansar, it's a sign of Iman. If you hate Ansar, it's a sign of Nifaq. So why is that? Because these people, the people who support the Prophet ﷺ, if you love them, you love them for the sake of Allah, because they support the deen, they support the Prophet. If you hate them, you hate the deen. Ali ibn Abi Talib, and the hadith narrated in Muslim, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, there is no one like Ali and love Ali bin Abi Talib unless he's a mu'min. And there is no one hates Ali unless he's a munafiq. It does mean like Ali bin Abi Talib is the, like the part of Iman and Kufr. No. Because he's from the family of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he's the one who support the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Fight with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He present Islam. If you hate him, you hate part of the Islam. So you are munafiq. If you love him, you love the Islam. You love him for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why they said the al-wala wal-bara, to love for the sake of Allah and to hate for the sake of Allah, it's awthaq ura al-Islam. It's the best pillar of Islam. To love for the sake of Allah, to hate for the sake of Allah. That's why the Prophet ﷺ said he will have complete iman. Who hate for the sake of Allah, who loves for the sake of Allah, gives for Allah, for the sake of Allah, and stop giving for the sake of Allah. Let's say you like your brother, but if you give him money, he will go do a lot of bad sins. So you stop for one reason, only for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then you have iman. So this is talking about the complete iman. When you really put Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger first, and then your desires. That's why the scholars, they said, if always Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger comes first, and then whatever you desire, you are a mu'min. If it's not, you are Muslim. Because you pretend, you say in your mouth that you love Allah and His Messenger. But it's not the reality. There is signs, there is some facts if you are Muslim or not, a mu'min or not. That's why the Prophet ﷺ always, when he said about لَا يُؤْمِنُ أَحَدُكُمْ لَا يُؤْمِنُ أَحَدُكُمْ, it's always about iman, it's not about لَا يُسْلِمُ أَحَدُكُمْ. Islam is like just to say أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ will be Muslim. So, any questions now about Islam, iman? Nothing? All good? Alhamdulillah. InshaAllah. So, let's ask you some questions before we finish this talk. So now, this hadith narrated in Bukhari and Muslim. So, what kind of hadith is this? Is it mashhoor, mutawatir, ahad?
Well, it has an ayah of the Quran in it, right?
No.
Oh, so the ayah was not mentioned in the hadith.
The hadith is that simple. Is no one will have believed unless the Prophet ﷺ will be more beloved to him than his son, his father, and all mankind. And Bukhari and Muslim.
And who is the person who
report the hadith?
Who is the Sahaba?
Anas bin Malik and Abu Hurairah. What do you think? What is mutawatir? I don't know.
Repeat it.
What is mutawatir?
No doubt. Many tens. Many.
MashaAllah, that's good. So is that mutawatir? No. Okay. So mashhur, they said there is a lot of parts, like 3, 4, but there is some doubts because 3, 4 maybe make mistake. Right? So now we have only 2. So is it mashhur? No? So it's ahad, but it's sahih. The ahad, it has sahih, hasan, da'if. how we can say this hadith is sahih? We said there is 5 conditions. Each one in the chain? Trustful, truthful, this is first. He has good memorization. And the sanad will be muttasil, which is connected. Because we can say this narrated from this person, from this person, but there is a gap between them. Like if you say Khairi reported from Umar, Khairi saw Umar, right? But if I say Khairi reported from Atatürk, right? It will be like there is a gap. I just want to remember like an old Turkish man, so I couldn't remember except this bad person.
He is the most famous man.
Yes. So there is a gap. If that means there is someone missing. So this hadith is not sahih. Because we don't know who is between you and the other guy. Okay? So, and you muttasil. And then, no shudud, no ilm. There is nothing against the hadith. So this is sahih. If the memorization of one of the people, a little bit, not really strong, he made some mistakes, we call this hadith hasan, which is acceptable. But if we have something against one of the, like the people in the sanad, in the chain, now the hadith will be weak. And it depends. Sometimes it's like so weak, sometimes it's like weak. If we know there is a guy who fabricated the hadith in the chain, we just see the name, say like, put a cross on this hadith. This guy, he fabricated hadith. He's a liar. We don't take the hadith. But if there is a guy, which is some people say he's good, some people they said no, he's not good, then we will say this hadith is weak. Or some people would say no, there is some people they really support this person. So it depends. Sometimes all people they said he's weak, sometimes some people they said we know him, he's good. Some people would say we know him, he's bad. So sometimes it's really hard to tell. But in general, the hadith is sahih, when all the chain connected, all people trustful, truthful, with good memorization. They don't usually make mistakes in the hadith. And they report all the letters, the exact. When there is one of them or some of them, their memorization is low, the hadith is hasan. And by the way, if we report hadith according to these conditions, if it's not weak, it will, our hadith will not be weak, will be like hasan. We will not reach the sahih. Because our memorization, comparing to their memorization, it's nothing. Like they used to like say hadith in a way, you will be really surprised. They memorized the names, the person, what he was saying, what where he was sitting, what he does. They even report the Prophet ﷺ, he did this, and he, for example, he was doing this when he said this hadith. And all people repeated during the time. So they really know what they are talking about. For us, oh, the Prophet ﷺ said this, and then you don't really know. There are some people, they took, like, there is some grammar talk. Just like to confirm the Arabic grammar. With the time people, they said, قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said this. And it's not, it's fabricated just to confirm the قاعدة, the grammar rule. That's it. Do you know the hadith when they say these days, they said it's not allowed to drink milk during eating what?
Salmon?
Yes, eating fish. If you eat fish, some people, they said it's not allowed to drink milk. لا تأكل السمكة وتشرب اللبن. It's not hadith.
They say it is hadith.
All people, they said, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. And it's not. But it's so famous that all, like people when they teaching the kids, they said, oh, لا تأكل السمكة وتشرب اللبن, لا تأكل السمكة. And it's command. Don't do this while do this. Don't do this while do this. So with the time, people said, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, and become hadith. And now, people just take it as a hadith. And so, yeah, sometimes, wallahi, I get really mad. Like, I explain to people, I said, this is not a hadith. And you shouldn't follow it. And some people said, okay, I'll follow it just in case. Like what? It's a qa'idah for the grammar. It's a rule for grammar. It's not for your daily life. Anyway, that's why I said, like, now if the scholars of hadith accept our hadith, that will be a mu'jizah. That will be a miracle. Because we can't really tell the difference between the hadith and whatever, like saying for anyone else. There is a hadith that the chain looks good, but all the scholars, they agree it's da'if. And I was like really surprised, like the chain looks clean, there is nothing wrong with it. And there is another scholar, which is a Dhahabi, he's from Muhaqqiqin, he's like very good scholar. He said, I was amazed about this hadith. The chain looks so good. It's like even like more good than any other hadith. But all the scholars, they said it's da'if. Because the talk is not the talk of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They can tell us this is not the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And they report this hadith as like fabricated with the chain.
In the chain itself.
Yes. They said this chain is not for this hadith. So subhanAllah, they can tell if the Prophet ﷺ said the hadith or not. And now, for us, we just take any hadith and said, this is what the Prophet ﷺ said.
What was that hadith?
Also, inshaAllah. I don't want to mention it now. InshaAllah. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين. جزاكم الله خير.